Hey guys, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. This is Ankush here from Alip Consulting. Today we are going to talk about Azure Application Gateway. Now let's understand what is the Azure Application Gateway is. So Azure Application Gateway is a web traffic load balancer. It's the that's enable you to manage the traffic on your web application. Azure Application Gateway provide you the application delivery controller as a service offer the various layer 7 load balancing capabilities. And it's used to optimize the web farm productivity by offloading the CPU intensive SSH termination to the gateway. Application gateway can make routing decision based on the additional attributes of an HTTP request, for example, URL path or the host header. Now, let's first understand why and how application gateway can help you to optimize the performance or provide the security for your application. So with the load balancer, if we go with the Azure load balancer, it's a layer 4 and it is going to be work on the layer 4 of the environment. And in that case, what is going to be happen? It's just going to route the traffic. It's not going to basically provide you any kind of security with the WAF or any kind of redirection and kind of SSL offloading. So it's just with the load balancer, it's just traffic is going to come on the load balancer, and based on the availability of the backend VMs, traffic will be routed to the server. But application gateway is a little bit advanced. It's the application delivery controller. So it's have a various features, like it's provide you the SSL termination, it provide you the security, it provide you the auto scaling, it provide you the ingress controller for AKS. You can use the application gateway. So these are the features which basically make the advantage of having the Azure application gateway. Another thing is, if you are using any kind of appliances like F5 load balancer on your on-premise, or you are migrating to the Azure, in that way, application gateway can replace that product as well, because application gateway have a same kind of functionality which F5 load balancer do, or the other hardware load balancer do. Same kind of functionality application gateway can also do. So here are the some of the features which application gateway have. As I've told you, secure socket layer termination, auto scaling, static virtual IP. Then ingress controller for AKS, URL-based routing, multi-site hosting, redirection, session infinity, connection draining, custom error page, rewrite HTTP headers and URLs, and the sizing. So these are the some of the features of the application gateway, which we can take the advantage of running the application gateway for our application. Well, here is a comparison between V1 and V2. So the major comparison come in the auto scaling. So with the V1, we don't have auto scale options, but with V2, we can have the auto scaling options. We can use a V2 application gateway with AKS as well, for AKS ingress controller. Then we can have a keyword integration for application gateway with V2 to get the certificates or upload the certificates. And a part of that, we can have a custom WAF rules, and we can have a WAF policy associations as well. So what is the WAF policy association? So as I told you, application gateway also support the WAF, which allows you to manage or provide the security for your application as well. So with the WAF policy association, what you can do, you can have a one centralized WAF policy associated with your multiple application gateway, and manage from the one single policy, and put the ones use the one single WAF policy to manage the security and across the multiple application gateway deployed in your environment. So that's what something which only available in the V2. Well, this is how your traffic is being routed. So if you see, in case of any user reaching to the application gateway or redirecting or requesting for a specific location like slash image or slash video, they will be routed to the specific servers in the backend using the URL based routing. Well, How to use Application Gateway? So primarily it's provide you the complete cloud-based, secure, scalable load balancing solution for the web application and service. You can use it with the any kind of applications, like if you're having a web applications or internet-based application, it must to have Application Gateway with the web so that you can have a security in place. You can have a control in place for securing your web application. It's provide you the load balancing as well. So let's take an example. You want to take the advantage of Application Gateway with web, and in the backend, you have a 10 VMs or 15 VMs running. Application Gateway will be also going to provide you the load balancing facility to route the traffic or send the request to the backend pools. It also provides you the SSL offloading, which is the one of the advantage of having the Application Gateway, because in this case, server is no need to decrypt the data and recrypt the data to send back to the user. So this is how you can use your Application Gateway. Well, this is how your end-to-end communication look like. So in front-end, Application Gateway is going to be have a front-end IP and the FQDN, which is going to be associated to the front-end IP. And then you are going to have a HTTP or HTTPS listener. In the HTTP and HTTPS listener, you are going to define for which URL or which DNS request Application Gateway can accept the request. And then it's going to be have a role associated with the HTTP setting and the backend pool. Through that, the request will be going to redirected to the backend servers or backend pool. So in our diagram, if you see, we have a multiple pools, like we have a VM scale set, we have external app services as well, or we have Azure app services. So this is, you can have a multiple backend pool configured for Application Gateway. So Application Gateway support wide range of backend pool, like a scale set, VM, external IP, or the app service, and you can use them to protect through Application Gateway. And then with the WAF, you create the HTTP or HTTPS listener, and then you create a rules to send the traffic to the backend pool. Right? Now, one more thing I would like to mention here, you can have two types of listener. One is the basic listener or one is the multi-site listener. Now, what is the use of having a basic listener or multi-site listener? The basic listener is only going to be allow you to run one website from the one Application Gateway. But if you are having a multiple backend pool in one Application Gateway, and those backend pools are basically running the multiple applications or on the different FQDN, then you have to create a multi-site listener. Through that, you can take the advantage of hosting a multiple websites through Application Gateway to the backend pool, and same way you can take the advantage of securing all of them by a single Application Gateway. Well, let's move to the demo. So in the demo, I will be going to show you how you can go ahead and create the Application Gateway, how you will be going to configure the backend pool, how you will be going to configure the routing rules and other stuff which is required for run the application or run the Application Gateway. Right? So let's move to the demo. Well, I have already logged in my Azure subscription. So to create the Application Gateway, what we need a virtual network, and we need a dedicated subnet for the Application Gateway. We need to make sure the dedicated subnet should not have any kind of other component except our Application Gateway. If you have any Application Gateway deployed in your virtual network or in a specific subnet in the virtual network, you can use that subnet also to deploy one more Application Gateway. But if your application, you haven't deployed any Application Gateway in your virtual network, you need to make sure the subnet you are using does not have any kind of resources deployed in the subnet. Well, let's confirm the prerequisites, which is a subnet, the virtual network and the subnet for Application Gateway. So in my lab, this is the second VNet, which is a Alif demo dash VNet 01. Is the one in which I have deployed my Application Gateway that will be going to I will be going to use as few of the demos. So let's first confirm. So in my VNet, you will see I already have an App Gateway subnet deployed, which is associated with the one of the Application Gateway. So I can use this VNet to deploy the application gateway. Let's move to the deployment of application gateway. So search for application gateway. You can and then in this page you can click on create. So once you click on create, you have to specify few information like a resource group, region, tiers, and the other stuff, right? So I am using this Alip demo resource group for the demo. So let me provide the application gateway name, and the location is going to be in central US because the my VNet where I have application gateway subnet that is also in the central US. So this is a region specific component. And then you have a plenty of other options, like you want to have a WAF or you want to have a normal standard application gateway. I would like to have a WAF, so I need to select the WAF V2. So there is a plenty of difference in between first and two. So if you see, if you selected the V1, you are not getting options to have the auto scaling. But as soon as you move to the WAF V2, you would be going to see the auto scaling is options available where you can have a minimum or maximum scaling instance for your application gateway based on the request coming to the application gateway. Well, I am putting it to, and then the firewall status is going to be enabled, and then the what kind of firewall mode is going to be. So detection and prevention. So detection is something in which it's just going to detect and going to create a log for that specific detection. But if you want to put that application gateway in prevention, what is going to be happen based on the security policy, which is predefined by Azure Application Gateway WAF, it will be automatically going to prevent that specific queries or the specific request which is coming to the application gateway. And application gateway, since that is not right for our backend infrastructure, that's a harmful for our infrastructure. So it will be going to be prevent that on the application gateway side. So we can put detection and prevention as per the requirement. But if you are doing it in production environment, first put in the detection for 2 weeks, see the logs, and accordingly enable and disable the rules, and then put this application gateway in the prevention mode, so that if you are running any kind of production application, that shouldn't hamper. Because sometime what happens, if there is any SQL queries or any database queries happening through the web application, so what happens? Application gateway understand that as a SQL injection, which is one of the type of the doing the attacks on the server. So that's something you need, application gateway need to be learned. So so in this case, what happened? You always put the application gateway in the detection, see the log, and accordingly you modify the rule and then put it into the prevention mode, right? So once this is done, once this configuration is done, we need to select the virtual network. So in my case, I already have application gateway running in one of my VNet. So it's automatically showing me the subnet which is applicable for the app gateway. So I'm using this subnet to deploy the this application gateway, which is with the WAF V2, right? And then we need to define the few configuration, like we need to define what kind of front end it's going to be, what kind of back end is going to be, and then we need to define the rule. So application gateway can deploy in two ways. Either you can deploy a private application gateway, either you can deploy a public application gateway, either you can take the advantage of both of them having on the application gateway as a front end IP. So in my case, I'm using it as a public application gateway. So I'm deploying a public front end IP for this application gateway. And then we need to define the backend. So we can add a backend pool. So in my case, I have already associated my servers with the existing application gateway, which I have deployed, and I will be going to use that application gateway for the rest of the demos. So you can add the backend pool and then click on yes, so that you don't need to add any kind of backend pools here. So this is just to put a first configuration, but later on, if you want to add more backends or you want to put more configuration, that's something you can do as well, right? And then you need to define the configuration, what is the front end IP is going to be, what is the routing role is going to be. So in my case, let's put it a rule one because I'm just creating it as for test, and then put the listener name, find the front end IP, and then define the backend, and then define the HTTP settings. So in the HTTP settings, you can set up the HTTP settings. So in the HTTP settings, you are going to be defined in which port it's going to be work on a backend. The backend is going to be on HTTP or HTTPS. So if it's going to be HTTPS, you need to define the certificate for that, so that it can get application gateway can connect to the backend server over the HTTPS. Right? In my case, everything is on HTTP, so I'm selecting this as a HTTP. Alright, you just need to click on add, and then you will see backend pool is automatically picked from the role configuration. That's it. You need to click on next. Next. And click on create. So as soon as you submitted your deployment, it will be submitted for the application gateway with the configuration which we have defined in our application gateway on the creation of application gateway. So it will be going to deploy with the same configuration, but later on if we need to add more backend pool or we need to add more rules, more front-end IPs, not more front-end IPs like having a multiple rules, having a multiple backends, having a multiple HTTP setting, that's something you can do later on as well. So let's move to the another demo where I will be going to show you how application gateway can provide you the load balancing. So I already have created the application gateway as I told you. So in my case, my application gateway, which is the app 02, is already have all the configurations. So if I go to the backend pool, you will be see this has two VMs already associated, and both of them having the test IS web page running on them. So if you use this public IP of the application gateway, and if you hit on this private IP, you will be see it's reaching to the one of the VM in the backend pool, right? So this is how application gateway can help you to access the website. Now, how the load balance is going to be happen? So let's say, let me open one more tab. So let's say, as of now, the application gateway is redirecting to the VM01. But let's say if your VM01 is down, right? If your VM01 is down, let me go ahead and stop this VM. Then what is going to be happen? In that case, application gateway will be going to redirect this connection to the another VM, which I have as a same backend pool, and the VM name is VM02. So let's wait for the VM to get stopped. And once this VM is get stopped, the request for this specific public IP will be redirected to the VM02. So let's wait this operation to get completed. Okay, so most probably this is in the stop deallocated mode. No, it's still running. I have put it that operation for VM01, I think. Yep, that is put it for a VM01. So it's in a stop deallocated mode. Most probably the VM is stopped now, but here status is not updated yet. So let's wait to get this status updated. As soon as this is showing as a stop deallocated, we'll try to hit that same public IP again, which is associated with the application gateway, and we'll see if that request is moving to the VM02 or not. Well, the VM is completely stopped. So let's go back to the public IP of the application gateway and again hit on this one. So this is still going on app 01. Okay, so now application gateway is going to be redirected to the another one because it's taking a little time to see if the backend VM is available. If the backend VM is not available, it will be going to redirect this connection to the VM02. It's not going on. Let open Let me open a one more tab and see what happened with this public IP. So as of now, this is still moving on app 0, sorry, the VM 01. That should move to the VM 02 actually, because I have a VM 02 running. So first of all, let's validate one thing: is the app 02 is accessible or not. So this is still going on app 01. I don't know why. So let me see if there is any typo on the page, something like that. So this is a VM in which I have another app running, and most probably let me see if you see it's going on app 02 from the VM IP, but with this one it's not going on app 02. I don't know why. So let's wait for some time. Okay, it's giving the bad gateway. It should not give the bad gateway. It's because I have a both VM here. That's fine. Most probably it's going to be take a little time to get this updated. So let's you see now the connection has been redirected to the VM02 and right. So this is how application gateway do a load balancing in between the VM and help you to redirect the connection. Right? Another things which you can do is like how you can go ahead and have a multi-set listener. So once you click on the listener, you need to click on the add listener, and here you have option to add a multi-set listener or a basic listener. In the basic listener, you just have options to define a front-end IP and the port and the listener name. But with the multi-site listener, you have a option to define the host name. Now, what happened when you having a multi-site listener? Application gateway is only going to accept the request for the host name which is defined in the listener. So, right? So that something is important when you having a multiple application running. With the multi-site listener, you will be able to host the multiple website on the application gateway. At the same time, it's also provide you the security as well, because when you having a multi-site listener with the specific host name, application gateway is only going to be accept that request from that specific host name. If someone is requesting for the host name which is not available on the application gateway, that's not going to work. And part of that, you do have a health probe to monitor the backend health as well. So in my case, I have a very basic setup, so I don't need a health probe. But in your environment, you are running a multiple website in the backend servers, it's always recommend to have a health probe so that application gateway can monitor the health of the backend server. All right. So that's what I have for you in the demo. I hope you like this video. If you like, please click on like and subscribe for upcoming videos. If you need any help, please feel free to reach us. Thank you.